What is up, everybody? It's Javier with the Enrichtifyers, and today we are looking at the YouTube Terms of Service changes. Now, before we start, I just want to give you an update. As you can see, I'm in an entirely new place. I have moved out of my the college town where I did college at Texas Tech, and I'm now back here. So I'm still moving in. I still got a few more stuff to put up, but I'm mostly moved in for the most part. And starting next week in a couple days, I'm going to be out of state to visit some family. So I'll so that's just something coming up. But after that, I should be more settled in, and I think basically everything should be moved in properly. So just wanted to give you a little heads up there to why this whole set layout has changed. But anyway, I wanted to go ahead and look at this YouTube Terms of Service update because I find it kind of interesting, but also a little bit concerning at the same time. And I just wanted to give you my take on it. Now, I'm no expert in terms of all these terms of service changes or anything like that. I'm not 100% certain of, I may not be 100% certain of what all this means, but I'm just going to go ahead and give my take on it based off what they sent me. So let's go ahead and get used, let's get into it. So it says here, you're receiving this email. We're updating the YouTube Terms of Service to clarify our terms to provide transparency to our users. The terms were similarly updated in the United States in November 2020. These changes shouldn't significantly alter your use of the YouTube service. So let's go ahead and look through this. So the summary of the changes. Facial recognition restrictions. The Terms of Service already states that you cannot collect any information that might identify a person without their permission. While this has always included facial recognition information, these new terms make that explicitly clear. Okay, so I'm not 100% certain what that means. Is that basically, like, you're not allowed to use facial recognition software on YouTube to try to find a person and find out their information, like where they live and stuff? I mean, if that's the case, then okay, yeah. I can see, yeah, I agree. Like, really shouldn't be searching for these people, I guess, you should, and stuff like that. I mean, like I said, I don't really know what that means. I would have to read that in more detail in terms of what that is. If it means, it says you can't use facial recognition software to identify a person and try to collect their information, you know, I guess that's fine. So, yeah, I don't really have too much to say to that. I think I would need more information to get a more point of care, but from what it sounds like, it's fine. But the next point is one that I think is what everyone is talking about. YouTube's right to monetize. YouTube has the right to monetize all content on the platform, and ads may appear on videos from channels not in the YouTube Partner Program. Now, this is what's concerning. What basically this means is that YouTube can run ads on any video it wants, on any user it wants, and even if they're not in the partner program, and that means that the channel in which that ad is being run on will not get a cut of it, it seems. Now, maybe it is, and maybe they're not making that clear, because, of course, this is a short sentence, you know, there might be more details that, you know, will be in the terms of service that I can look at to get more info. But based on this alone, it sounds like YouTube is going to is going to run ads on whatever channel they want, and it seems like the channel will not get any money from that ad being run on their channel, no matter how many subs or how many views their channel gets. And that seems a bit scummy to me, if that is the case, because that's not how it works in the advertising world, okay? When you run an ad on television, whatever channel it may be, they gotta get, you know, a cut of it. You know, because the station is letting this advertiser run the ad, so the advertiser must pay the channel to have that ad run. That's how it works. That's how you make money. That's how it works in the business. So if like you have an ad, if I have ads being run on my channel, and I'm not getting a cut of it, you know, I feel that that's a bit disingenuous and a bit scummy. I mean, that doesn't seem fair, especially, let's say, if you are a popular YouTuber and, you know, and let's say you're not monetized for whatever reason, you know, they can still run ads on it, and many people could probably see the ad, maybe some makes a lot of people go check out the product, maybe even some buy the product. That channel's not going to get a cut of that? I mean, it's their channel. You know, that's the most concerning thing regarding this new term. Yeah, I don't know. That just seems scummy to me. If a person is having ads being run on their channel, and they don't have a say so of it, that they say like, oh, I don't want ads on my channel, and if YouTube is taking that say so away, and saying no, we will run ads on whatever videos or channels we want to, and you have no say so, then I feel what you could do is at least provide some money because these channels are providing the platform, are providing the channels, the users, the viewer base to see these ads, you know. Again, it seems a bit scummy to me that YouTube will run ads on your channel and not give you a cut, if that is in case. Maybe you will, but it's not stated in here, so then I'm just going off what's in here. So maybe I will have to look at this in more detail, maybe we all have to, but we'll see. So next one, not fully certain what this means. So royalty payments and tax withholding. For creators entitled to revenue payments, such payments will be treated as royalties from the U.S. tax perspective, and Google will withhold taxes where required by law. So I guess in terms of a certain revenue that creators earned in terms of the U.S., like some of it's going to be taxed, or, you know, Google will withhold taxes, I guess, operated more like, I guess, a paycheck or a payroll or something, you know, like how when you go work a job, you know, there are certain taxes that you have, that are, there's money taken out of your paycheck to go towards taxes. I guess maybe it's the same thing or similarly. Again, I would need to read more into this to really get an idea of what this means exactly, because I'm no expert on this. Please make sure you have read the updates carefully. The new terms will take effect June 1st, 2021 for users outside the U.S. So I guess this means that this doesn't apply to anyone who works in the United States. So these terms of service are only for channels outside the U.S. So I guess that means it won't affect me, because I am in the U.S., but that's just an interesting point. This is only going to apply to people who work on YouTube outside the U.S. But so yeah, these are the new terms, and while some of it I seem like fine with, it's mostly the YouTube's right to monetize that is a bit off-putting, and I think is what mostly people are talking about in terms of these new YouTube terms. So like I said, maybe we need to go get more information and see, in terms of this right to monetize, and see, like, is this going to be fair to the creators in which, like, you're running ads, even if they don't want to? Is there some kind of compromise or anything? Again, just maybe more information needs to be given, and maybe I can look further into this to get a better understanding, because this is definitely not enough information to understand what this term means, and I need the term explained probably in more detail. So anyway, I just wanted to share this with y'all. So thank you for watching this video. If you liked it, leave a like and subscribe for more videos regarding culture or news or even movie reviews. I'm still going to be making movie reviews. I do plan to make the part two of The Boys season two in-depth critique and analysis. I'll probably start on that after I get fully settled in and all that. But again, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Take care.